Psychologist Abraham Maslow once said, "If the only tool you have is a hammer, you tend to see every problem as a nail." After World War II, that hammer was nukes. So when America needed to build a shiny new highway to replace iconic Route 66, come on, what else would we use? In the early 1960s, the US government hatched a plan to set off 22 nuclear bombs in California to blast a path through a mountain range for Interstate 40. This was no fringe proposal. Studies were done, budgets were allocated, fallout maps were drawn up, which they would need since the closest town was just 10 miles away from the blast zone. It's obviously an absurd idea. But the level of planning that went into this project shows just how serious it was. In fact, the main reason why it didn't happen has way more to do with red tape than anyone stopping to ask if maybe we shouldn't nuke ourselves. This is the story of Project Carryall. So back in the late 1950s, America was really into two things: not being the Soviet Union and building superhighways. Up until that point, driving long distances across multiple states meant navigating a patchwork of parkways, toll roads, and two-lane regional routes. But that wasn't gonna fly for President Dwight Eisenhower, who saw firsthand the benefits of a true nationwide freeway network in Germany as commander of Allied forces in Europe during World War II. America needed its own autobahn.
They're calling it a freeway.
This wasn't just about helping move people and goods across the country faster. The massive new highways were also pitched as part of our national defense, allowing troops, supplies, and yes, nuclear weapons to be moved around quickly if the Soviets invaded. That's why in 1956, Eisenhower signed the Federal Aid Highway Act, essentially creating the modern interstate highway system and committing the US government to footing 90% of the cost of construction. The United States is about 28 times bigger than Germany, with a much wider range of environments that highways would need to cross. In some states, building one out was pretty straightforward. Existing routes were widened, poor inner-city neighborhoods were leveled, standard stuff for the time. But especially out west, the extreme terrain was a huge challenge. That's one of the reasons why Route 66 became so iconic as the American road trip. For decades, it was the main way to drive from Chicago to Los Angeles, a thin ribbon of civilization strung across some of the harshest and most beautiful landscapes in the world. But it was also pretty slow, being a simple two-lane road winding through small towns and mountain passes. That all began to change when construction started on I-40, a major cross-country freeway stretching from North Carolina to California that would provide a much more direct route through the Southwest. For perspective, the drive from Chicago to LA is about 400 miles shorter today than on the original Route 66. By the early 1960s, I-40 was coming together as smaller sections were being finished and linked up, except the very western end in California. There was still this 150-mile stretch in the Mojave Desert between Needles and Barstow, where tiny old Route 66 was the only connection. And annoyingly, an entire mountain range called the Bristol Mountains sat square in the path of the direct route planned for I-40. You can guess where this is going.
An atomic bomb? Ow.
Building a roadway flat, straight, and wide enough for highway speeds through a mountain range requires moving an absolutely massive amount of earth. You could spend years slowly chipping away at it with TNT and backbreaking labor. Or you could do it in a day with a couple dozen nuclear bombs. The incredible idea of using nukes for large-scale excavation projects wasn't new, though it had never been done before. On purpose, I mean. What was new was a federal initiative launched by the US Atomic Energy Commission in 1957 called Project Plowshare that sought to find peaceful uses for nuclear bombs. That name comes from a quote from the book of Isaiah about an army beating their swords into plowshares for the good of the people. Although, like with the highways themselves, it wasn't really about helping mankind. Actually, the stated goal of the program was to convince Americans that nukes were useful so they'd keep supporting weapons testing and development. As the government toyed with ideas to impress people, like blasting out a new harbor in Alaska, didn't happen either, a few forces converged on the Bristol Mountains. One was the I-40 project, and the other was the ATSF, or Santa Fe Railway, which wanted to build itself a new freight line through the same area. And so, in 1963, a plan called Project Carryall was drawn up to detonate a string of nuclear bombs underground to excavate a 2-mile-long, 350-foot-deep trench through which the highway and rail lines could be easily routed. Two birds with 22 nukes. As a concept, Project Carryall was simple. Engineers would drill a series of 36-inch wide holes to depths between 343 and 783 feet, line them with corrugated metal, carefully lower in the nuclear bombs, and then hit the switch. The combined force would be 1,730 kilotons, or about 115 times that of the bomb dropped on Hiroshima in World War II. The explosions would take place in 1966, construction would begin in earnest in 1968, and the highway and railroad would be operational by 1969. But as with many things in life, the real appeal was saving money. The cost of carving that route through the Bristol Mountains with traditional methods was estimated to be about $50 million, or around $500 million today. And while nukes aren't exactly cheap, Project Carryall was estimated to cost just $22 million. That alone was enticing enough, but it also helped that scientists back then had a, shall we say, evolving understanding of nuclear fallout. Again, the tiny town of Amboy was less than 11 miles from ground zero, but across hundreds of pages of government reports on the project, everyone kind of waved their hands at the issue. The explosion would be underground, and plus, the government was developing cleaner nuclear fusion bombs that would throw off less radiation. A 1963 report estimated the Carryall blast zone would be safe enough to enter within a few days and ready for construction without unusual safeguards a few weeks after that. Possible damage to Amboy was a footnote, far less of a concern than accidentally cracking a nearby gas pipeline. Still, planners did acknowledge that this was all unproven, and the just-take-our-word-for-it approach to fallout management seemed sketchy. Before work could begin, the Atomic Energy Commission wanted to perform a pair of test explosions in 1963 and 1964 to better understand how nuclear excavation would work in practice. For various reasons, environmental studies, budgets, the slow pace of government approvals, those tests never happened. By early 1965, the commission still thought it could pull everything together in time, writing in its annual report to Congress that Project Carryall would be, quote, feasible, safe, and otherwise possible and desirable once testing was complete. But it was out of runway. In 1966, with the project now years behind schedule, California's Department of Highways decided it couldn't wait any longer and announced it would build Interstate 40 with conventional methods. The plan to nuke a new highway into existence was officially dead. Not because we realized it was a terrible idea, but because the gears of government just moved too slowly. How about that? A story where red tape is the good guy. The Bristol Mountains section of I-40 was finally completed in 1973. As for Amboy, it was never irradiated, but it still suffered a slow death without the tourism income that came from Route 66. Today, the only school, motel, and diner have all closed, and the population is now less than 10. The devastation that the interstate system had on small Route 66 towns like Amboy is undeniable, and we could honestly do a whole other video on that. Or you could just go watch Cars. You know, same difference.
Route 66? It's still here!
Yeah, that's great, kid.
As for Project Plowshare, it was eventually shut down in 1977 after 27 separate tests for various mining and construction purposes, but without a single successful project on the books. Even the tests were a mixed bag. Just one example, in 1967, the Atomic Energy Commission detonated a nuke thousands of feet underground in New Mexico to try and unlock a natural gas deposit. Turned out, it made the gas radioactive, and the site was abandoned shortly after. So what are the chances of Project Carryall ever going according to plan? Today, the journey from Needles to Barstow on I-40 is 45 minutes faster and 30 miles shorter than on Route 66. And while it might not be as scenic or romantic, at least we dodged it becoming an irradiated wasteland. And yet, aren't you just a little curious about what those 22 blasts would have looked like? Anyway, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.